Just think for 1 minute and tell me the answer. Commander, you ask the question. So what first teacher is doing, just delivering the lectures in the class for 1 hour and giving you assignments, giving you questions to be solved at home, right? At home, when everything is understood in class, I know, right? Everybody says, yes, understood, this is fine. But when they are at home, students are at home, when they are solving the activities, the problems, they face the difficulties, there they need the teacher to help, where teacher is unavailable. The concept of flipped classroom is this. Like this is the traditional one. I know some of the students have watched. These are the screenshots I took from IIT Bombay X platform from the course which both of us have finished. So this is the traditional one. Information transmission in class. We give you information to the students, alright? And assimilation, assessment or perceiving that knowledge with help of assignments and questionnaire, we do outside the class at home where actually students need us. Flipped classroom is this now. Information transmission outside the class, assimilation, activities, solving the problems, solving the assignments, helping the students when they need in the classroom. Getting my point? So, information transmission through different kind of things, maybe MOOC, maybe OER, on which I'm going to talk, maybe YouTube video. I will just tell you, okay, there is one video, just watch and come in the class. So you will watch it, you know, if that is recorded by me, then you can pause me if you are bored, which you cannot do right now in the class. Right, you have to listen to me. Right, then you can pause, you can, you know, repeat, you can just pause in between, sleep for an hour and again you get back and listen. So all that transmission information is done outside the class. You come with a difficulty in the classroom and we are there as a teacher to help you. So what difficulties you faced, let me know and how that is solved. So that is nothing but a flipped classroom. Now let me actually begin with my presentation. Sorry. Now I am going to definitely blend it with the help of some kind of resources, some kind of videos. Definitely we are going to learn in different ways. And I thank the previous speakers, Kadakne sir and Dernekar sir, because they have made my task very easy by giving so many references. We are going to actually visit those sites. I am going to show you the screenshots of those and we are going to see what exactly we need to do to get those OERs. Alright. So what exactly OER stands for? It is Open Educational Resource or Resources. Alright, as it itself suggests, it is open to all, it is related to education, and there are certain kind of materials that you are supposed to use for your research. What we are going to see now in just next course of time is what exactly is OER, what are the characteristics of that OER, why OER now, what is the need, what are the different types, right? Why they are beneficial for us as a teacher, as a student. Creative Commons licensing is something new. How many of you know about this CC? Creative Commons licensing. It's very interesting. We are going to see about that also. What are the available resources which we can use? Then what initiative is taken in India on this OER, like Soyam and Dad sir just talked about. What are the challenges and limitations of this OER? And creating your own video OERs, I'm going to show you my own sample. And how to utilize those OERs in our classrooms. With one example like WhatsApp in class. I am using WhatsApp in class. I'm going to just share that experience with you. So before this, let me just focus again. Let me make you realize why online learning is so essential. I'm going to show the video which was nominated for a kind of award, and this is called as 21st Century Digital Natives, a must teacher watch video. Of course, there are a few teachers, but definitely some of you, I just saw in the morning, some would like to become CA, businessman, but definitely, anyhow, you have to end up with being a teacher. So if you would like to be a teacher, then definitely you have to just pay attention to this digital native, what that person is saying. Is the simple and powerful idea that the world's knowledge is a public good, and the technology in general and the world wide web internet in particular is providing an extraordinary opportunity for everyone to share that knowledge, to use that knowledge and reuse that knowledge as per their need. The meaning of this OER is nothing but it. Alright. Now, one more video on the OER.
Education is a fact. It enriches our lives, sustains our communities, and helps us grow into the future. At least, that's the idea. Truth is, education as we know it is failing millions around the world. Take time to creativecommons.org/education to learn more.
This webinar is going to help you a lot to know about open educational resources and careers. So can you tell me what are the characteristics of this OER? Just with this 2 minute short video. What OER stands for, what OER is. It is Open Educational Resources, of course. What are the characteristics of this OER? If they are open, right, they can be, you know, edited, they can be shared, they can be remixed with as per the need of the local people, and they can be updated from time to time, which a book cannot, or with a book which we cannot do. So let's move further. It is open educational resources which are teaching, learning and research materials in any medium that resides in the public domain or have been released under an open license that permits their reuse and reuse, repurposing and reuse. So simply what OER stands for is they are teaching learning resources which are in public domain, they are free to use, they can be used by anybody, anywhere, anytime. These are certain characteristics of these OERs. We are going to see the types, but let me just focus on characteristics first. They are digital in nature, right? They are open, they are free. Then, can be used by anyone, anywhere, anytime, for any purpose. Of course, they are free of cost, right? There is no assessment like in MOOC. You have to do a particular course, you have to face the assessment, and then you will be given a certification. But here OERs are there which you can just learn from your own, and there is no need of any assessment.
and it fits with an individual and autonomous initiative. No tutoring. Like if I want to learn how to play music, how to play guitar, I can just go on internet, go on Google and find out and learn on my own. If I want to know about economics, I can simply start with Googling like basics of economics. I'll get thousands of resources, OERs, and I can just start learning on my own. Can you tell me what is the problem in that? If I would like to learn economics and I just Google on internet, like how, what exactly is economics or how to learn economics, what problems do you face when you are Googling, searching on Google?
Exact knowledge,
or you get thousands of resources. If you just search simply, you will get at least 1,000, you know, different resources, and research has proven that 90% of the people do not go beyond the first page of Google search. पहिल्या 10 मध्ये जे येतात तेच फक्त बघणार. पेज नंबर 2, पेज नंबर 3 गुगल जात नाही 90% ऑफ द पीपल. अँड द गुगल टेल्स विच मोस्ट विजिटेड साइट्स ओनली. पहिल्या याच्यात क्लिक करतोय, सगळे क्लिक करतात म्हणून ते पहिलं जात आहे. सो द प्रॉब्लेम इज वी आर नॉट एबल टू फाइंड आउट एक्झॅक्ट ओईआरस. वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाऊ टू फाइंड आउट एक्झॅक्ट ओईआरस एज पर माय नीड. These are the 5 R's which exactly tells you the characteristics of this OER. We can revise that if I prepare my video on communication skills, or if I just prepare a video on grammar, I can revise that as per my need. If I get updated my knowledge, I can simply go to the video on YouTube and I can just revise that. I can remix. This presentation is nothing but the remixing of all the OERs. I have taken some images, I have taken some videos. Right, I have included some information and created one OER that is on how to use OER. So it can be remixed, it can be reused. I'm going to keep it as it is here. Any of the teacher can just get the PPT, learn on his own or her own, just remix it, remix the same thing and just give presentation to other teachers. So we can use remix, reuse those OERs. Redistribute, you can just share those, you know, on WhatsApp you are getting many videos, that's nothing but distributing the videos with others. And retain, if I like that, I can download the video, I can download the course, I can download the book and keep with me, retain. So these are the 5 R's of this OER. So this is the same, using, remixing, adapting, creating your own, finding proper OER and sharing with others. Now, as sir had just discussed, the characteristics or disadvantages of traditional classroom and the advantages of MOOCs. Just you can see to that side, sharing beyond the classroom. Traditional sharing is an educator, a teacher like me, prepares his or her own notes, distributes those notes with certain learning activities or notes to the students. This is my class, I prepare my notes, chan me keda tayar kela and jharos kurun kulana dile. The limitation is just, it is limited to these. What exactly is OER? Just with some kind of additional considerations like copyright and formatting, I can just designate that as an OER, maybe recording video, maybe creating PowerPoint and sharing it on SlideShare or Scribd.com. It gives opportunity for the speakers, so the learners worldwide, they can just simply visit on the site that I'm referring and they can learn the things. So it is open education for all. Okay, one more. Why OER? Why there is a need of OER these days?
For the longest time, human societies evolved very slowly. But since not so long ago,
this opportunity has been made available by the OERs. And I just, madam, asked whether it has a credit or not. Yes, now UGC I don't know about, but AICT has definitely made it mandatory for final year students. You know, engineering final year student, they have to complete one MOOC and there are 20 credits kept reserved for that MOOC. You have to select any MOOC from your field, civil engineering, mechanical engineering, whatever course you may be in, and you are supposed to complete the course, produce the certificate, get 20 credits. And I guess in coming 4 or 5 years, UGC will also come with the same and you will be given this freedom. These are the courses.
These are the Hello. What are the courses? Hello.
Okay, so ICT in education. You know, we call it as a mechanical barrier. Mechanical barrier. It is not my barrier, it is just created because of some problem in system. Alright, we have just overcome those and go ahead with it.
So in coming 3 years, you are definitely going to get an opportunity to learn the course that you want at your own pace and get the certification. And definitely, I see the teachers are scared. Like if you learn everything online, then what we are supposed to do? I'm also a teacher. You are going to contribute a lot by doing the same thing. Because even if I say that students, this is a great video, just watch it and come tomorrow, and I'm sure on week 2 of TV quality, watch it in the class. Right? Then that was serious. Of course, before that, as a teacher, I have to watch that. When students come in class, I have to just do some activities so that they will feel sad that I should have watched the video. And then they will feel the importance of the teacher. And then we start our own lecturing. Alright? So let's move further. What has enabled OER? I just skip it fast now. Socially, the open source kind of internet now is available, and the philosophy has, you know, made it very easy. It is a social. Knowledge is a social product, should be get in the society. Then talking about technically, simple example, Jio. Right? Now it has given you one GB data per day. Right? Previously it was 700 MB for 500 rupees for 1 month. You know, even if I would like to check my email, I would just do it very fast and close immediately. So that's the data. Today, Jio has made it very, yeah, that is the fact. Jio has made it, you know, very, very easy for you people to access anything on the net. Right? Then, legally, now, legal aspects are definitely some kind of, you know, of importance there. There are some kind of licensing ways which are giving or making you people to use anything as per your own, need. Like if it is copyrighted, we are going to see how limited that is. But now there are some kind of new licensing software, new licensing things which are making it free. And financially, there are so many supporting funding agencies who are helping us as a teacher to create my own OERs and give it to the students. OERs, what exactly OER, Open Educational Resource, stands for? These are some examples. They can be textbooks which are available digitally online. They can be videos. YouTube is the best bank. Test banks which are already available on internet. You have to simply download that and use for the students. Use, as a student, you can simply give the test and score or just check your knowledge. There can be images. This is just one example of image. You know, if I put in everything one below the other and go on explaining, that will have less impact than this one, right? You are just saying in a kind of an image. Then there are certain software, and there are courses at the end which all together put modules and learning objects. These are a few examples of OERs. Why OER? What are the benefits of this OER? Number one is there is less production cost. If I would like to complete or do a course from IIT Bombay, I have to go physically there, attend the classes, make my accommodation and all that. It will definitely cost something. But if I find that IIT person, IIT professor is recording all that knowledge into 30 lectures and giving it on IIT Bombay tags, I can simply enroll myself there and learn that course on my own. Every day one video enough. If I miss this day today, I can just watch the video tomorrow, and in that I can complete the course. If you are enrolled officially, you will get the certificate. If you are not enrolled, you will not get the certificate. That's only the difference. Alright? Then easily available, like anyone, anytime, anywhere. You can just simply, you should have internet and smartphone, of course. Everybody is smart enough. Then downloadable and adaptable. You can download, you can change as per your need. Durable, they will be there as long as internet will be there. Right, a book, if it is, you know, after at least 100 years, it will have kind of damage. But these OERs will be there forever. Flexible, updatable, you can update those. And benefits, learners with different places. The great example is, if I am talking on a topic here in the class for 1 hour, then there may be some students who may be learning, getting it very fast. There will be some average students who will be getting it moderately, but there will be third kind of category who needs some more time to learn. So you may have to pay more attention here in class, but if it is recorded one at home, you can just revise the thing, you can pause, you can just rewind, and again you can watch the entire video as many times as you want. That is the benefit. Now, why open matters? What is open licensing? You must be aware about this. Copyright, all rights reserved. Means what? If you find a book with copyright, even if you would like to use a single sentence from that, you need to take permission of that author, without which you are not allowed to use. Just the example happened there before in my college. Nana Patekar was there to visit to promote his upcoming movie, Ablamanus. And one of the faculty members just created a banner on which he used the Nana Patekar's image. And the program was over. Many students shooted that and put on YouTube. And next day itself, we got a call. Okay, I'm speaking this. And the image that you used on your poster is clicked by me. Did you take my permission? Right. Now, YouTube, of course, internet has made that person realize if my image is being used without my consent. Immediately, our principal has to make an apology letter and say, hey, without your permission to use, sorry, this will not happen again. And please excuse us this time. This is the restriction given by copyright. Now, if I say this is my own presentation, nobody can use, he will, you know, run after getting copied somehow, and just because there are so many references. But if I keep it open to you with this kind of thing, Creative Commons, it gives opportunity to both for users and for creators. For users, it is, you know, open licensing enables us to reuse the works of others, then share our own works, build upon existing work, adapt existing works, as well as some rights users, like I can give some kind of licensing, like what I would like to do with this presentation. I want you people to use as it is, I want you people to mix it, I want you people to use it for commercial purpose, I want you people to distribute it others to others like I have done, and so on. But no restriction at all. You can use it, there are certain restrictions. You can just find this image to this side, public domain, no any kind of, you know, right on the material. If it is in public domain, anybody can take and anybody can say this is created by me. Kavita is not there. Kunaji Kavita Anaichani Kaisandavechi and Kunaji Majaki. So that is public domain. And this one is the restricted one, copyright. Tomorrow permission have is lucky. In between, there are certain types of licenses. Number one, there is CC BY, means you can use it, reuse it, redistribute it, and so on. And you could also have commercial, non-derivative, change portion of my non-commercial, and so on. Of course, it needs more time to understand how to get the licensing. But this is the site Creative Commons from where you can get the license. I guess at the beginning of this presentation, in the first slide itself, you must have seen this presentation by Mahesh Shinde is Creative Commons under this. I just booked that on this website and I have got it. You can see it even here also. You have to simply answer some questions, and at the end you get presentation on OER by Dr. Mahesh Shinde is licensed under that. I will just simply give there, means if people are using that, they will just acknowledge that I have taken this presentation from this person. How to find out OERs now? Like sir asked, Google on the full material I want to use price. So let us say that students are using from your institute, students from outside the organization are using, and of course teachers, researchers are using that. Simply if I put something on Google, I'll get these results. Alright, because Google is common, and I just check first, second, third, fourth, tenth. But very few people go beyond the first page, and 10th page nobody goes. 3rd page beyond nobody goes, this says. Forget about 10th and all that. Right. So what to do in that case? Instead of searching in Google, you can simply search on this website, OER Commons. Alright, so there are So if you would like to get any OER, it is not needed that you should get only OER or search for the OER list limited to your commerce field. If you would like to know about English, go there. If you would like to know about music, engineering, software development, medical, anything, just go there, find out what here you are supposed to just put what you are looking for, which subject domain you are looking that particular information, and education level, standard, or so on, you will get thousands of results. Out of that, you have to choose. There can be courses, there can be videos, there can be books, there can be tests, there can be presentations. You have to just check and you have to download and use for your purpose. Learn online or again for your own use. This is just one example, but you see so many. Alright, so I'm going to talk about 10 different types of OERs. Talking about general search, we usually go on search on Google. right? Which does not give us all the available resources which are under Creative Commons. So instead of that, if you would like to only visit Creative Commons, like the OERs which are licensed one and created only for the sake of education, go to CC Search. ccsearch.com or .org, simply go there and put videos on commerce, videos on economics, videos on business, whatever subject you would like to do. You will find all the videos, you will find the books. Simply, no better distractions, so the break INRI, only education related things. Then, if you would like to take photos or images, right, your thousands of websites, out of those CC Search, Wikimedia Commons, Flickr, Google Images, Pixabay, OpenClipArt, library and so on. Right, if I would like to give a chart of tenses in English, so I will, instead of going to Google and chart of English tenses, then it will give different kind of results. Instead of that, I may go to Flickr, I directly may go to Pixabay, I may directly go to Google Images itself or CC Search and simply put image, I will get the exact image which is prepared for educational purposes. Then talking about video search. Video search, usually we simply go to Google and through Google, YouTube of course. But there are so many other kind of sites which are giving you different kind of videos. Out of those is Vimeo. You can simply just go to Vimeo and find out various videos available there. Internet Archive, like it is giving you most of the old videos, you know, which you usually don't find in YouTube or on Google. Then TED, Ideas Worth Spreading. This is nowadays, I guess, rising a lot, and so many research activities are being shared there. In fact, tomorrow there is a TED event in our college in Kolhapur, first time organized. Being a faculty coordinator, I have been taking care of all that for last 1 month, and I was almost beaten by all my volunteer students. Sir, would that event time to be asked Kolhapur as alai? I mean, we have organized TED event. 8 now people are coming, they are there in Kolhapur now. Tomorrow we are going to host that event. The specialty of this site is you have to express everything that you have special with you in just 18 minutes, maximum 18 minutes. It is a lot of YouTube only TED Talks. Baga asmas, TED Talks or TEDx Talks. To live view the Monday, every available, easily available, all the researchers, all the people have given, well of people given their talks there in 15 to 18 minutes. For audio and music, further Google and analytics, you can go to these particular three music archives, SoundCloud and so on. This list is given there. Now, if you need general education search, you would like to just search for general education. You can go to this OER Commons that we have just seen. Now, what this OER gives you is it is associated with over 120 major content partners to provide a single point of access for educators and learners. Right? There are 30,000 plus items available on it now, and you can find and provide descriptive information about each resource and can link up the ones you need. It is not the case that only available OERs you can download. If I have my own, I can upload there for others. Next is the Orange Grove. Again, the next very great resource about the educational resources. It is a wide range of K-12 and post-secondary resources, right? And it focuses more on remixing, sharing and contributing educational resources from all the fields. It is particularly for school students, but you can simply just check if when I search on business and commerce courses, I found around 17 courses, 17 resources available on this site. If you are aware of this NASHEDSEC open courseware, a huge repository of all kind of lectures given by the experts in their universities, the college, and it is made available for all. So the aim of this NASHEDSEC Institute of Technology is that is to adapt advanced knowledge and educate students in science, technology and other areas of scholarship that will best serve the nation and the world in 21st century. With this, now almost all the European countries and Western countries, they are coming with OERs. Now definitely India also has taken initiative and they are also approaching towards this. But they are far away definitely from us, right? Now there are so many the courses offered by them. You have to simply find course. Just put it here what you would like to find out, you will get the results, you have to simply go visit and learn.
These are the courses.
And I just found economics as one course there. You can simply click and go and find out. This maybe you are aware about Khan Academy.
Yes.
Actually, open education started with them. Khan Academy. Right. Now all kinds of videos are available. As a teacher, as a learner, as a parent, three segments are there. You have to simply go and find out what exactly you would like to do. The specialty of Khan Academy is they are very short videos and they are prepared with the help of some kind of animation on the board. So which looks as if you are learning in a classroom. This is the section I found there in Khan Academy related to economics and finance. Microeconomics, macroeconomics, finance, capital marketing, entrepreneurship and so on. You have to simply click there, get your information. L courses, I just talked about open L courses. Like you have to simply go and find out the courses that you want. Now the class, a lot of your teachers like to ask, it's very difficult to understand the people, the teachers from L. Alright, that's why they are there and that's why it is open, reusable. It is not the case that you can exactly the person. And it needs, when we were in IIT and preparing, in our FDP, Professor Bhatt, who just recently got Padma Shri Award for his work in ICT in India, he simply said, as a teacher, if you need a preparation in your regular classroom, you may spend 1 hour. But if you would like to deliver a lecture with the help of ICT, you need 4 to 5 hours preparation. In the same way, students are also, be ready with spending more time. Read, listen to the video, watch the videos again and again. Now there is the task of we teachers, Indian teachers first. It is expected that we teachers just learn the course and mold it in our own way and produce that for the people who are, around us. One more is open learn, dive in the ocean of knowledge. Simply you are supposed to go and find out the courses. These are just based on a short that I have taken. There are a number of done. Right? There are money and business is one. Here you can find economics and so many other courses. Click on that course. Now, this is not private or prepared by private providers. These platforms are giving you resources prepared in well-known universities. Alright, so most of the foreign universities, they are doing it, recording it now and keeping it open for all. Now instead of going to their university site, we are supposed to go here and we will find all the courses together. Academia Earth, the huge, resource of online courses. You can find here accounts, business, finance, economics, and if you only are underlined. These are the universities which are providing you or the videos of those universities, courses of those universities are available here. You are simply supposed to search and find out. When I just search free online lectures and courses for accounting, I simply search and found these in results. Financial accounting, view course. You are simply view the course, watch the video, get the knowledge. That's it. Simply you search and go ahead with. Then this is of University of Oklahoma. In the same way, open textbooks, if you would like to search textbooks, these are some of the sites which provide you textbooks. Open textbook, library, BC campus, open ed, college open textbooks, open stacks college, boundless, and so on. Nowadays, if you would like to get a book, you have to spend at least 100 rupees. Can you get that book free? Of course, if the author has given the permission. Right, but most of Copyright Act finishes, after 99 years. All the books are available now here on those sites. Modular courses means what? Short kind of information which you can add up and prepare like a course. These are some sites which provide you those modular courses. Connections or QD or Merlot or Wiki Educator, Wiki University and so on. Complete course, like Sir just talked about this edX, this is a MOOC provider. All the previous ones are the OER providers. You have to get the chance and learn the things. But if you would like to learn everything about financing, go to edX and Coursera and some others and just search there, you will find the same courses. You can just see here, business and management is one which is related to you, economics and finance. Once you just go to edX, click there, economics and finance, what courses so far partaken, list will be there. Your courses, you are supposed which are upcoming, you will get that list. You will just have to enroll. After a week, you will get email that first week courses, course material is available. You have to go online that week, watch the video, solve the task. 1 week's work is done. Next week, you will get next assignment, next videos, next assessment. It can be 7 weeks course, it can be 1 month course, it can be 3 months course. Every week you will get, not everything at a time. So that you also stay interested. Now, complete courses. This is economics and finance courses. When I searched on this domain, I found some of these, but the list is more down. This is just one screenshot. You have to simply click and go ahead with. This is Coursera.org, where again you can get so many books available. You have to simply register yourself and your course starts. Just think it, if you would like to get the certificate, you have to pay for that. If you do not want to get certificate, it is pure cost. You have to simply learn and test your knowledge. Okay? So it says access to 1,800 plus courses from the world's best universities and university partners. Right? Everything available even in the best or in the universities. The domain is engineering, humanities, medicine, biology, mathematics, business, computer science, and so on. Around 20 million registered users are there who are taking enrolled in this particular course, and there are around 2,000 plus courses as on 2017. So these are some other examples of complete courses along with edX and Coursera, Carnegie Mellon University Open Learning Initiative, Open Course Library, MIT Open Courseware, Open Courseware, UK Open, Seller, and so on. You simply go there and register yourself. This is Open Textbook, Wikibooks. We usually search on Wikipedia. Go to Wikibooks, you will get the books. Wikipedia only articles. Books, you will get the books in PDF form. On your own. If when I searched in commerce, just simply commerce, I found these available books on this particular topic. And the results are 750 results on commerce. So at least those number of items are available on commerce on Wikibooks. This is again a great journal. If I want to see what latest research is going on in my field, I need to either physically get that journal or subscribe that journal online by paying. This is open access journal, like directory of open access journals. Whichever journal is providing access to them, the whole list of the journals is available here. Right? What you are supposed to do, simply go and search what field you would like to get. Simply I have to commerce. And for that, I have found 57,906 articles. They are coming together and they are giving their best resources, which will be available there on this particular platform. I hope that all the teachers and all the students will register themselves today itself on this platform, right? Because once you register with your domain, you will start getting emails, right? If this new course is available now, if you are interested, go and register there. Just enjoy the course. Alright, so when I found on accounting for manager, just essentially search with their book accounting, there are 30 scheduled courses found but the result is yours. You find that more jobs are created. We need to just change ourselves. As a teacher, we need to make it blended. We need to make it flipped and use it in classroom. Next one is moral rating of teachers, students and parents. Students also should be given confidence, teachers also need to be given confidence, and along with those, parents also should be made aware about this kind of open educational resources, so they insist their students, and of course government initiative. Right? Now we are fortunate that we are getting that kind of enforcement from our government. That is all about OERs now, available OERs. I'm going to just give an example of how to create our own open educational resource. As a teacher, how can I create my own video and give it on YouTube so that students can use that? Right? So there are different, like I can prepare my PowerPoint presentation, I can write a book and paste, I can just prepare some kind of test and give it on the Moodle so that students talk on that, how can I give it open to all. And I can even record my own lecture and give it on YouTube. Open to all, right? So there are certain video, I'm going to focus on video OER,
There are certain softwares, Screencast, Automatic, CamStudio, RiverLine, Xcore, Plasm, and so on. Out of which, I am going to show you how Screencast, Automatic can be used to record your own video and how that is going to be useful to create your video OER. Okay, so instead of explaining me, let us see a short video of 1 minute or 2 minutes, I guess, on how to use that particular Screencast, Automatic.
Welcome to screencast.com. Let's start. This is Dr. Mohsin Bhatt from Google Scholar in the background. I'm going to talk about the transition program.
Let's start with the course on that.
The activity of our team.
AIT Division A. All the 65 students and all the 10 teachers are there on the group. If I would have to share something, I will simply share on the group. Easily it is visible to all the students. No need to waste time like first thing in the morning, as well as papers, printing it and putting on the notice board, making students every day should go and read the notices and so on. So simply keep go on putting all the notices there on official WhatsApp group. Then what I did is, for teaching types of sentences, I shared a link of video on types of sentences with them on WhatsApp a day before. Just I found out, I watched that video, I watched 10 videos and found one very interesting and simple for them and posted the link of the same to them. Next day, found only if you have watched. As usual, I say, Bahi Kaka, instead of funny or apart from funny things, they will not, students will not watch. I found that only 10% of them have watched. So what I did, the same video of 7 minutes, I played in the classroom. Next, what I did, played the same video in class and discussed using this EPS. EPS stands for Think, Pair, Share. I give a topic to you, make you think for 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, pair, you discuss that topic with your friends sitting beside, pair, and once you share with your pair, discuss with your pair, you are supposed to share that in the class. That is EPS. Then I use that and what are the types of sentences and so on. Then next, conducted online quizzes, posted links to quizzes on WhatsApp and made them solve. So what I did, you have learned the video, you have discussed. Immediately I, started my mobile and I said, start your WhatsApp. Everybody was looking at it, no? Start your WhatsApp, sir. Mobiles are not allowed in class. You are telling us use WhatsApp in class. So they were very, very eager, they got excited. Immediately they started WhatsApp. Anyhow, everybody is with smartphone. Just like a net pack, I have hotspot, all for the Gatla luggage. I just posted a link of the quiz online. They visited the link, saw that quiz, result is there itself, and they shared the screenshot of their result on the same with their roll number and the score. So I found that it is creating some kind of interest among the students. I further continue. In the evening, quiz time on WhatsApp, very enthusiastic response. What I did, Sandhya Kai Gurukar part was late, we all are online, I put another quiz. Quiz in the sense, link to the quiz. I post the link, immediately the people visit, they solve the 10 questions and 10 out of 10, 100 out of 100 screenshots sharing. Division, roll number sharing. Now I teach 3 divisions, so what I found is, 3 divisions, everybody is putting on their official groups and disturbing all the teachers. So what I did, I created my separate group and invited all those 180-190 students to join that group through join the group feature in WhatsApp. Within 5 minutes, 190 students joined my group and now I started using that quizzes on that my group. I just shared some screenshots here. This is the group back to Intel. Learning is alive. Now I want rest. That is active learning. That is sharing, OER, and it is nothing but a group classroom. Again, I did something in the afternoon, right? I again did something a day before, and I did something on the very day to engage the students to learn the things. So this is just one example of using my OER. In short, this is just a snapshot of what OER is, what types, how, and everything about OER. It is good. Learning is alive. Now I want rest. That is active learning. That is sharing, OER, and it is nothing but a group classroom. Again, I did something in the afternoon, right? I again did something a day before, and I did something on the very day to engage the students to learn the things. So this is just one example of using my OER. In short, this is just
a snapshot of what VR is, what types, how and everything about VR. It is good to take videos. You will understand everything about that. If you have any queries, my contact details are there. You can contact. Thank you.